सो हेलो एवरीवन एंड वेलकम बैक वंस अगेन टू दी टुडे सेशन ऑफ कनेक्शन डिटेल्स। ओके सो वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट प्रिपरेशन ऑफ ऑटोकैड ड्राइंग्स ऑफ स्टील स्ट्रक्चरल कनेक्शन। ओके सो इन दिस सेशन आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन हाउ टू प्रिपेयर कनेक्शन डिटेल्स इन ऑटोकैड फॉर बीम कॉलम कनेक्शन फॉर बीम कॉलम कनेक्शन। ओके सो व्हाट यू कैन सी हियर वी हैव टू प्रिपेयर दिस द कनेक्शन डिटेल। ओके सो हियर वी हैव कॉलम आई एस एच बी 300 एंड बीम आई एस एल बी 400। व्हाट यू कैन सी दिस इज द सेक्शन एलिवेशन हियर एंड हियर वी हैव द साइड व्यू। ओके that is if you look from this side, if you look from this side how it looks, that you have to show in side view. Okay, and we have the connection details here. This is very important, so this part is very important here. Okay, so we have a seat angle ISA 130 by 130 by 10. So what do you mean by seat angle here? If you see, this is a seat angle. Seat angle means where the beam rests. Okay, beam sit over that angle, that's what is called as seat angle. And below that seat angle we have stiffening angles. These are the stiffening angles. So here it is given stiffening angle, stiffening angle or stiffened angle, ISA 90 by 90 by 10 for length of 280 mm. So this is the length here it is mentioned, 280 mm. Okay, and this is for sectional elevation and side view. We have to prepare the plan also for that. Okay, in plan what you can see, that also you have to show. Okay, so we have again the statement of the problem here, so I'll show you. So here we have the given statement of the problem: draw to a suitable scale beam to column stiffened seat connections for the following details. Column is ISHB 300, beam is ISMB 400, seat angle 130 by 130 by 10 mm, and cleat angle 90 by 90 by 6 mm, and we have the stiffening angle which is given here, pair of stiffeners, 2 ISA 90 by 90 by 10. Then you have to use 10 numbers 20 mm diabolts for stiffener to column in two rows, and 2 numbers 20 mm diabolts for remaining connection. So this is very important here. So here we have to use 10 numbers of 20 mm diabolts to connect stiffening angle and column flange. Okay, in two rows means 5 bolts in one row, so total 2 rows means 10 number of bolts. And for other connection, for making other connection, you have to use 2 numbers of 20 mm diabolts. Now we'll proceed with this. Okay, so here you can see we have how many numbers of bolts? 5 numbers, 5 plus 5, total if you see here you have 10 numbers, 2 rows 10 numbers. Okay, and other things if you see here, they are asked to use 2 number of bolts for other connection. Okay, so here what it is shown, 2 numbers of 20 mm bolts for making the connection. Okay, now we'll proceed with the AutoCAD. Okay, you can use the separate CAD drawing, or you can prepare here only. So you can copy this, or you can make a like this and you can prepare it somewhere here. Okay, or you can, if you want, you can prepare it in separate sheet also. Okay, now what we'll do, we'll draw the sectional elevation first. Okay, so we'll go to AutoCAD. Okay, already again I told you in the previous session also, again I'm repeating here, so you have to fix the units and limits first. Okay, already I have fixed my units and limits. So before proceeding any drawing, what you have to do, you have to fix the your limits and units. Okay, so I have already have done in my sheet, so I'll proceed with the drawing. So we'll draw the column first. So we'll draw the column here. So for orthogonal you have to use F8. Okay, then the column size is 300. Okay, so we'll have the offset of 300 mm. Then here this is 300 mm. If you want, you can check in dimension style. So this is 300 mm. Here you can see it's a 300 mm. Okay, then the thickness of flange also you have to show there. Okay, so for that you have to refer steel table, and by referring steel table I got the thickness of ISHB 300, the flange thickness of ISHB 300 is 10.6. So we can use offset 10.6. Okay, so you can write 10.6 and you can have the offset here. So this is the flange. Okay, now I'll delete this. Then after that you have to show the beam here. Okay, so I'll little bit stretch here. Okay, then you have to show the beam connecting to this. Okay, so we'll draw a line here. Then we have the beam. What is the size of the beam? 400. So that you have to show it here. So again, use offset 400. So 400 mm. Then you have to show the flange thickness of beam. So again, for that you have to refer IS or SP1, which is called as steel. So for ISLB, the flange thickness is 12.5. ISLB 400, the flange thickness. So offset flange thickness 12.5. So 12.5 we have to show here. Okay, then this again you can stretch it inside, little bit inside. Again, you can stretch and you can show the cut section here. Okay, like you can show the cut section, but for timing I'll not show here. Again, you can stretch this little bit inside. So this much is enough. Then we have to show the angle here. So we have to show the angle first. Okay, so the 90 by 90. Okay, so what you have to do, you have to show the angle. So here the angle is 90 by 90, the angle here it is 90 by 90. That angle you have to show, that is called a split angle. Okay, so here I have shown the angle 90 by 90. Okay, so you can check in the dimension style also, the angle size is 90 by 90. So this way 90 and this way also 90. So again you can use the fillet command here. Okay, you can fillet it. Here also you can fillet it. Okay, so this is the size, the clit angle ISA 90 by 90. Then you have to show the stiffening angle and the seat angle. Okay, so for that we have the stiffening, seat angle is 130 by 130, that will show first. Okay, that is the stiffening angle ISA 130 by 130. Okay, so here what you can see, the seat angle ISA 130 by 130. If I want to show in the dimension, so here it is 130 by 130. Yes, okay. Now again you can fillet it. Okay, so this is for seat angle. Yes, now the next what you can see, you can again make it with a different layer by using layer. So for beam I have used one layer, for column I have used red color layer, then for angle to highlight, okay, I have used the yellow color layer. Okay, so this is for the clit angle and the seat angle. Now we have to show the stiffening angle here. So what you can see here, the stiffening angle is this. Okay, that angle is 90 by 90 by 10. Okay, that you have to show here, and for a length of 280 mm. Okay, that we have to show it now. So here we have the two angles, that is 90 by 90. In this way it is 90. If you want again check in the dimension side by measuring the dimension, so this way it is 90. Okay, 90. Okay, so this way it is 90 by 90. I'll take it down little bit. Okay, so this way 90 by 90. Okay, then this is the regarding the connections. Okay, now we have to show the bolts. Okay, the seat angle and even the clit angle here, and now we have shown the stiffening angle. Okay, now after that we have to show the connection details. Okay, so for connection details they have given the number of bolts are 5 bolts you have to show here. Okay, so here connecting 5 bolts to the stiffening angle and for the flange of column. Okay, now we'll show that. Now to show bolts, I have divided into the 5 spacings, because 5 number of bolts you have to provide, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so now here the bolt you have to show. So I have drawn a bolt here, that is for the rectangular section. Okay, now what you have to do, you have to hatch this. So you can use hatch command, hatch, you can use pick point or the select object. You can say preview, and if it is fine, say okay. Now what you do, you have to copy this with respect to this So you have got 5 number of words. You can see here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. And for making the connection between these two, again you have to show two words. So I'll show it in the center here. So you can use same here. Rectangle. So here one bold, and as well as here. We can show actually the bold shape size, even the nut, everything, but for timing I'll show only this. Okay, so again you have to show hatch command, select object, this and even this. Okay, so okay, see, now this is the regarding the connection details. Now we show the dimensions. This is 400, this one is 300, okay, and this dimensions is 280, and this is 130 by 130. That also if only can show, this is 130, this will also is 130, yes, and this is 90 by 90. This also you can show this way, and for other things you can use leader command LE. Like this, and you can use the dtext to show the text. Here you can show ISA. Ninety by ten. Okay, and say enter. So this you can make it vertical. So here we have ISA 90 by 90 by 10, and same you can copy his, and you can show it like this is the seat angle ISA. We have the seat angle ISA 130 by 130 by 10. Can edit this. You can show 130 by 130 by 10. Okay, and regarding the stiffening angle you can also show that. And for this you can show here this is ISLB 400, LB 400, and even this as 300. Okay, so this way you can show the detailing part. Okay, now we'll draw the side view of that. Now you have to do the detailing of this part. I would like to highlight that. Okay, this part you have to complete, that is for side view. So we'll have this detailing. You have to show the bolts, cleat angle, seat angle, stiffening angle. Okay, so this way you have to prepare the side view of this plan, sorry, the cross section elevation. So when you look from this side, if you look from this side, okay, if you look from this side how it looks. Okay, so you can see the beam connected to the column, and we have the vertical column which is in red color. Okay, then now the next is you have to show the angle here. Okay, the angle section. So for that again I'll match the property here. You can use match property MEA, so you can match this like this. Okay, and the even thickness you can use offset 10 mm. So this is a 10 mm offset, and for this again the seat angle which is in yellow color, I can use match command. Offset of 10 mm, so it's a thickness what you can see. And here we have the, again I'll match property here. So this is for the seat angle. This we can make it dotted if you want, and go and load here from the dotted. Okay, say okay, say set current, and say close. Okay, Now this I'll make it while here, and for this I'll make a dotted line because it is hidden between the, it is back side of the Stefan angle when you see the side view. And from the here you have to make center. So from this center up to this we have, I'll make this as regular, so I'll match this. Okay, there is 90 by 90. So first is thickness, offset 10 mm thickness. So offset, the leg length is 90, so this side 90, this side 90, and the, so it's 10 mm. So the thickness of this and the thickness of this. Okay, and I just trim this. Okay, this way. Two ISA 90 by 90. Okay, and we have to show the bolts. So for that again, you can use the extension line or the construction line. So you can use horizontal construction line. Here you have to click and you have to press H enter. Okay, this you have to click it. This, okay. Now here you have to show the circles. So I'll show you here. So for that I can use magenta. I think I have shown in white color only. So I'll use color circle. So this, okay. So I can copy this. So before that we'll have hatch. So use hatch command. Pick point. Okay, say okay. Now just copy. Sorry, I'll repeat. Okay, just copy this now. Okay, now delete and say mirror. Can use mirror command for this. Okay, so we have transferred the 10 number of bolts, and for this connection you have 2 bolts, so you can use for making this connection. So again hatch. So we have prepared with the side view also. Here you can see the 2 bolts connecting to flange of beam and angle, and another 2 bolts here connecting angle to the web of column. And here we have the 5-5, that is the 10 number of bolts in 2 rows. Okay, now if you want to show the detailing again, you can copy the same thing here. So column you can copy again same this. Here we have the beam, and for column you can copy. Don't have to retype or this thing, you can use the same. And here if you have ISA, okay. And so now we are stiffening angle to ISA 90 mm. So you can copy this and you can keep it here, okay, like this one. Okay, so this is regarding the elevation, cross section elevation and side view. Okay, so by using this you have to prepare same, you have to prepare the plan of the connection. Okay, so it's easy. Okay, so I have already explained how to draw the cross sectional elevation and side view. These two I have already explained. So by using this you can prepare the detailing for plan. Okay, now regarding this, again if you get any queries you can have a discussion in comment box, or you can contact me. Okay, and regarding this again, you can create in different layers, so it will be look beautiful. Okay, it look nice when you create in layers. Okay, so for representing the different detailing part, if you create in layers it will be good. Okay, and regarding this again, if you get any queries you can contact me. Okay, thank you very much.